Hello, welcome to This Week in the Index. I'm your host, Grayson Brulte. This Week in the Index was designed to highlight the Road to Autonomy Index. The Road to Autonomy Index is comprised of 38 publicly traded companies. It's a high-definition lens into the emerging world of autonomous vehicles. The Road to Autonomy Index is the first and only pure-play index designed to measure the performance of the autonomous vehicle ecosystem and companies that have identified autonomy as a key component of their growth strategies. For the week of May 29th, the Road to Autonomy Index returned 3.40%. The NASDAQ 100 returned 3.97%. The S&P 500 returned 2.57%. Individually, the top performing stocks in the Road to Autonomy this week were Tesla, which returned an impressive 17.45% this week, followed by Qualcomm, which returned an 11.11% return, partly, in our opinion, driven by the AI boom we saw around NVIDIA, and Amazon, which returned 8.77%. How much of that was driven by the NASDAQ today and the Amazon cell phone mobility prime tier coming? Possibly, but one thing tells me, a mobility tier is coming. After all, they own Zoox. While these stocks perform well, they're just three of the 38 publicly traded companies that are components of the Road to Autonomy Index. News and opinion drives the market, and this week in autonomy, it was a tale of two cities, to quote Charles Dickens. In California, the California State Assembly voted 54-3 to ban autonomous vehicles weighing over 10,000 pounds from operating on public roads without a safety driver. While over in Arizona, Waymo's expanding fully driverless operations to 180 square miles in the greater Phoenix region. That includes Phoenix, Tempe, Scottsdale. It's really important to note that Waymo's operations in the greater Phoenix region are revenue generating operations. Not only is Waymo generating revenue, they're doing us all a huge favor. They're helping to usher in the public trust of autonomous vehicles. Thank you for that, Waymo. When the fall and the winter roll around, tourists visiting the region in Arizona will be able to take a Waymo, fully driverless vehicle, from the airport to the resort. Creates a magical experience. Went to Arizona, rode an autonomous vehicle. Alphabet, Waymo's parent company, is a top 10 constituent in the Road to Autonomy Index. And as the years expand, we expect to see Waymo operating fully driverless revenue, generating passenger operations in more than a dozen cities by the end of the decade. That's right, more than a dozen cities. With regards to the Waymo Via division, which is their autonomous trucking division, we expect to see revenue generating operations ramp up in the back half of this year with a large focus on the Texas market. By the way, Texas is the autonomous trucking capital of the world. I repeat, Texas is the autonomous trucking capital of the world. Well done, Team Texas. Fast forward a year from now, 2024, it's going to be a big year for the autonomous trucking industry as several of the companies are publicly projecting driver out operations, which we expect those operations to take place in Texas. In addition to the autonomous trucking deployments we're seeing in 2024, we're watching the port shipment volume to see if the trend of declining ocean freight volume continues at U.S. West Coast ports and what impact that's going to have on autonomous trucking legislation. In 2017, the U.S. West Coast ports share of ocean freight volume was 50%. Today, this number is closer to 42%. While you can contribute the drop in ocean freight volumes to a changing global supply chain, one thing's for certain, California is not friendly to automation. And as we've seen countless times, opposition to all forms of automation over the years, California just moves forward to stop it. It's sad. It really, truly is sad. And folks, you can't make this up. To quote Governor Gavin Newsom of California during a Q&A with Russ Mitchell from the LA Times after a speech on May 25th, the governor stated, and I quote, "The future is here. Driverless technology is here," end quote. Governor Newsom, he's correct. Autonomy is here. Autonomy is a business. Most importantly, autonomy creates jobs and autonomy is good for the economy. Autonomy is coming. That's right, the autonomy economy is coming. Yet California continues to stifle innovation even though the future is constantly invented in California. The iPhone, invented in California, manufactured in China, but it was invented in California. The truth is that autonomy will have an impact on each and every industry around the world, making them more efficient and productive. Take John Deere, for example, another constituent in the index who this week promoted Jami Hinman to SVP in addition to his current role as CTO, Chief Technology Officer. Why is this important? It's a move that reflects the vital role technology will play in the success of Deere & Company. By fiscal year 2030, every John Deere tractor will be autonomous ready. Well done, Team Deere. Deere, along with the other 37 component companies in the index, are not only preparing for an autonomous future, they are preparing to prosper with autonomy. Autonomy will be part of their business. Uber, which is another component company in the Road to Autonomy Index, is prospering under the leadership of Dara Khosrowshahi. Uber stock has returned 56.66% year-to-date. What makes Uber so exciting is that the company is now truly operating as a platform. It's a platform. Way to go, Mr. Khosrowshahi. Well done, sir. With autonomous vehicle ride-hailing partnerships with both Motional and Waymo, Uber's leaning into that platform, and now they announced a partnership with Swerve Robotics this week, which was spun out of Uber, to deliver up to 2,000 autonomous bots delivering Uber Eats orders autonomously. Again, Uber is playing to its strength and embracing autonomy by being a platform. At the end of the day, autonomy is a business, and not a buzzword. Gone are the days when executives on earnings calls use the term autonomy or autonomous to gain market credibility. That fad, then, it moved on to blockchain. Now it's with AI, and soon it'll be a new term, and the cycle will, frankly, start all over again. While the term autonomy or autonomous is no longer a major buzzword on earnings calls, the term autonomy is a business term and a technology that's being implemented to drive real, meaningful value in revenue for companies to the benefit of society and shareholders. As the autonomous vehicle ecosystem matures, the Road to Autonomy Index will mature. We will track it, but at no time can there be more than 45 component companies in the index. For a company to be considered for the index, they must be publicly traded on a recognized exchange for 365 days. They also must have a minimum market capitalization of $2 billion for 90 days prior to the one-year anniversary of their debut as a public company. In addition to having a 90-day daily average volume of $500,000 or greater. Why? Because autonomy is a business. It's not a science project, so we built an index to track its performance. Be sure to follow the Road to Autonomy Index on your favorite finance app with the ticker Autonomy. Again, that's Autonomy. AUTONOMY. Follow Autonomy Index on your favorite app. Be sure to join us again next Sunday for the latest installment of the Road to Autonomy's This Week in the Index. The future is bright, the future is autonomous, and the future is a thriving autonomous vehicle ecosystem.